Blackstone presents Moon Dark Smile by Tessa Gratton. This book is read by Sarah Naughton. To Robin McKinley and Karen Lord. The river is a flat, shining chain. The moon, rising, is a white eye to the hills. After it has risen, it is the bright heart of the sea. Li Po. Translated by Florence Eskew and Amy Lowell. Names. Sunrise. Sunrise was a common name throughout the empire, likely because it represented hope and joy, just like the dawn. Many children with the name were first born or born after a long struggle. Most grew into cheerful, happy adults, though a few took the name and ran in the opposite direction. Contrariness was always a risk with such an obvious name. But this Sunrise, the first and only child of Sira Bear Mistress, was given the name because he was born several months after his father died in a violent magical battle with the sorceress of the Fifth Mountain. Sira had clung to the growing spark inside her through her desperate grief, keeping herself alive for the child of her defeated lover, Skybreaker, the sorcerer of the Fourth Mountain. She swore the child would grow in remembrance of the sorcerer's glory, a monument to it, and a gift of revenge. Thus, Sunrise was named Sunrise, a promise of that soaring splendor. By the time her child was 6 years old, Sira sent him down the mountain to be raised by her sisters, a coven of some 17 witches and priests vowed into service and scholarship. Sira had been one of them, but she had abandoned their work when she fell in love with the fourth sorcerer. As the only child in the enclave, Sunrise was entirely spoiled. Fortunately, the abundance of love only polished his laughter into something easy to share and filled with compassion. He never knew suffering, always was encouraged, and when the aunties laughed at his escapades and mistakes, it was done with an air of familiarity. They taught him to read and cook and clean, to punch and dance and wield a sword. They taught him history and music, how to draw, and how to win graciously. Among the 17 of them, there was very little they could not teach. Sunrise learned it all, and though he had his preferences for warfare and music, his strangely perfect memory meant he could recite or recreate even what he considered boring. He was so pretty, dimpled, and friendly, his aunties always took him to the market with them, to visit nearby manors for tutoring rich children, or to replenish blessings at crossroads shrines or scholarship temples. He chattered away as they traveled, held their hands or darted ahead, smiled innocently, and never realized it was his adorable charm that helped this aunt haggle or that aunt squeeze into the last room at an inn. The only scar on this surprisingly idyllic childhood was his reluctance to ask his aunties to stop treating him like a daughter. It was not their fault, they did not know, because he never corrected them when they assumed he was a girl like them. Sunrise did not truly believe they would flinch, much less judge him for being his true self. It was only that this was an enclave of women, and he feared he would be asked to leave if he told them he wasn't one, and never would be. So Sunrise left the secret a secret, only curling up at night and wishing for a day when he was old enough and brave enough to confess to the family he loved. His mother made it easier to hold tight to his secret, for Sira was sharp and violent in her expectations. The widow was determined to carve her child into a weapon against those who'd caused Skybreaker's death. When she was not up the mountain wrestling with wild sorcery, she told Sunrise tales of his father's vast strength and clever machinations, of shape-shifting and intricate spells that took months to carefully draw to completion. She said Skybreaker had been the most handsome person, the tallest and most ambitious. Too bad Sunrise was delicate and compact like his mother. But she said that Skybreaker had loved three things: his great spirit, Sira herself, and Sunrise, even unborn. "They took him from us. You are alone because he is dead," she whispered late at night when she came down the mountain for a visit. Then she sang a soft, strange lullaby in a language he should have learned from his father. Sunrise did not think he was alone at all. He had his aunts, his dogs, and canaries.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.